Over the last few years, we have used Humana Day to show how climate change is affecting countless people across the world, especially vulnerable communities in developing countries. We have also shown that adaptation to and mitigation of climate change is possible. Humana projects in particular work to increase community resilience and build a sustainable future for all of those involved. But we don't have to travel so far to see how climate change is affecting our world. Even in industrialised countries, we're experiencing more intense and more frequent climate-related events, like unprecedented heatwaves, floods, and droughts. But what does this mean for our daily lives, and what can we do about it?
I don't know.
I'm not sure if I can change anything.
I want to know how climate change could affect my life.
Every product we own has a life cycle. We use essential resources and release greenhouse gases in every step of this process. Take a t-shirt, for example. This simple item of clothing uses about 2,700 litres of water just to make, as well as various chemicals, pesticides, and dyes. When we throw it away, it releases chemicals and greenhouse gases as it decomposes in the landfill. One of the simplest things we as consumers can do is to separate our clothes for reuse instead of throwing them away.
Linear economic model which Europe has developed since the Industrial Revolution, take the resources, make a product, consume it, and then dispose. We all know that resources are finite and the population growth is quite stunning across the globe. We're going to reach probably 9 billion people by 2050.
Do you recycle?
No,
not really.
You should do this. Yeah.
I'm trying to, like recycling, although there's all sort of story actually with that, taking care of the water, trying to, you know, manage the water in the better way and not consuming as much as we should.
Well, it's important when we reuse or we recycle any material, like textile, for example, or another material, normally is a clear relationship with a less level of greenhouse gases emissions. This is because we need to extract less primary materials with a heavy intensive energy process, and we need less energy that normally this energy is provided by fossil fuels.
Look around you, smell. It's disgusting, it's terrible.
Look at the weather everywhere. If you see what's going on all over, there's floods everywhere. I mean, you had extreme winters. I mean, there's a lot of crazy things going on. There has to be some changes.
We're consumers, but we're also producers of waste. And so much of this waste is unnecessary waste. So much of this waste is fruit of negligence and fruit of a non-consideration of the value of what goes into the products that we're using, consuming, and then disposing of.
In the past, everyone would bring their bottle back, get the milk bottle with milk in it, delivered at home, etc. So it was true circular economy. We would not throw away bread and we were repairing our clothes and things like that. So I think we need to make a step back a little bit.
Thank you.
It's very funny because in our family we have now a tradition: when we buy something, we have to throw something else or give it away, so we're recycling to people that are in need. Or, you know, instead of throwing things, we're trying to give it a second or third life.
There are many, many ways to make an industry more sustainable. But for me, the most important one is what we term industrial ecology, namely to consider industry itself as an ecosystem in interaction with the rest of the ecosystem. The basic idea behind is to design products and processes just as nature would do it, namely design thinking in terms of ecology.
And if you take clothing, for instance, you need to buy raw materials. So sustainable sourcing comes into play. You would rather buy cotton that was produced sustainably to produce your clothes than in unsustainable conditions damaging the environment in other parts of the world.
Fashion world are trying to educate us in the fast fashion concept. You know, it's like you can use this, but in a year it will be like out of trend. I think the fashion industry is like starting to be more conscious of the environment problems day after day, because there are a lot of fabrics that are already made. I don't know the technical process, but thinking about that.
Some brands also they recycle to do another new clothes with the old
still,
so that's really good.
Can donate our used goods, such as clothing, so that someone else uses them. And they're often in extremely good conditions. You just don't like them, we've grown too fat or something, and you just want to get rid of them. Someone else will be happy to use them, and then you save a tremendous amount of resources.
Do you think that each person can make a change in their own lives that can help the situation?
I think we all have to make an effort, much more than we do now.
Especially with clothes, when we buy a new thing, we have to give away one of the pieces we had, so we're not, you know, accumulating things, but trying to pass it on to the next people.
What happened was one of our year 11 classes decided that they wanted to recycle clothes. So the students took on a project and they asked me to find somebody to help us out. So I just surfed the net and I found Humana, and I read into the mission of Humana, people to people, and I thought, this is what we need.
Awareness is really built from childhood, and many countries which I speak about waste management repeat that it's extremely important to tell children at schools already what to do with their waste. If you stop, then the awareness will decrease.
Each year, Humana member organizations collect and prepare 130,000 tons of clothes and shoes for reuse.
Noi penso che riutilizzando almeno nel nostro piccolo, come fare la raccolta differenziata, come cercare di riutilizzare il più possibile le cose che usiamo quotidianamente nella vita, come anche gli abiti, questo è un piccolo gesto, è una cosa che aiuta.
For every bin full of donated clothes that we collect, we can prevent up to 10,000 kilograms of carbon dioxide from being released into the atmosphere.
fatto di avere dei cassonetti e in qualche modo attraverso l'azione nelle scuole o di sensibilizzazione della popolazione, attraverso un semplice gesto, riempirli con indumenti che non vengono più utilizzati. La visione generale impostata da noi rispetto alle politiche ambientali si declina anche fino al rapporto con Humana che ci produce questi risultati. Quindi soddisfazione massima.
Humana verifica tutti i vari passaggi della filiera. Oltre di fare la raccolta, facciamo la cernita, facciamo la verifica di ogni capo per valorizzare la donazione delle persone. Abbiamo dei negozi tipo charity shops in Europa per poter vendere questi capi e in questo modo valorizzarli. Abbiamo la possibilità di spedire vestiti presso il nostro progetto nel sud del mondo e quindi anche valorizzare i vestiti proprio presso le persone svantaggiate nel sud del mondo. Ma non finisce qui, perché se un capo può essere ancora utilizzato, ridarlo a qualcuno che può usarlo o metterlo in vendita e si rientra in un circuito post-consumo, ovviamente salvaguardia l'ambiente.
Different countries approach the same issues.
Making visible something which is true in every human act.
So when we reuse or we recycle any material, in fact we are contributing to build a more resilient world.
Textile reuse beyond numbers and ciphers is really, really important, and it's really in your hands.
That we have to do a lot more than we're doing now.
You know, it is possible. I think so, yes. Like she said, everyone has to do their part.
I would like people to think about it, especially for future generations.